So how do you define probability? Like if we have event E and we have sample space. So how do you define the probability of an event? Even class, what is the classical definition of probability? Okay, so I will write the formal definition. So this is actually axiomatic definition. So you might have seen like if E is an event. So let's say suppose E is an event and S, let's say sample space. And if all outcomes of sample space E are equally likely, then usually we define probability of event E as. So we define probability of event E as number of element. So we defined number of element in set E upon number of element in sample space. So you might have seen this definition. Yes, am I audible?
वॉइस ब्रेकिंग
ओके, आई थिंक ओके, सो इज इट बेटर नाउ? और
सर
okay, so what I'm saying, we have to define probability of an event. Okay, so we have to define probability of an event. So the definition I'm writing, this is called actually axiomatic definition of probability. Okay, so this is axiomatic definition, and the definition is like so the probability of an event A. Okay, so event, you know already, I think event is a subset of sample space. So probability of an, and what is sample space? Sample space is all possible outcomes, set of all possible outcomes. So the probability of an event A is the sum of. So actually I'm continuing lecture na, by last class, so I'm continuing the lecture, so you might have seen other definition before. So the definition of an event A is the sum of the weights of all sample points in A. Sample points in A. Okay, so therefore, the probability of A will be always more than equal to 0, less than equal to 1, and the probability of empty set or null set. What is the probability of null set? Anyone would like to say? So, what is the probability of empty set?
Zero.
Zero.
It is zero. Yeah, correct. So zero, and the probability of sample space is what?
One.
It is one. okay. So the definition I'm writing from the book, okay, so I have given one book, so I'm following that. So in different book you may see different definitions, okay, so I'm following that book. So usually probability of event is defined like that, in the beginning, just introductory part. So E is an event, then probability of E is number of element in set E upon number of element in sample space. Now in other way they are defining the same thing. So the probability of event A is sum of the weights of all the sample points. So sample point is what? Each outcome in the event. So they are saying probability of A will be more than equal to 0, less than equal to 1, probability of empty set is 0, probability of sample space is 1. Furthermore, so furthermore, if A1, comma A2, A3 and so on, these are, so this is a sequence, okay, this is a sequence of mutually exclusive event. Mutually exclusive event. So mutually exclusive has other name also, we call it disjoint. Mutually exclusive, or you may say disjoint events. So if A1, A2, A3, so on, this is a sequence of mutually exclusive events, then, okay, so what is the meaning of mutually exclusive? Anyone can tell me? So when can we say two sets or two events A and B are mutually exclusive? What is the definition of mutually exclusive, or what is the definition of disjoint? Yes, anyone?
Sir, if A intersection B is null.
Yeah, correct, correct. So if we are talking about two sets, A intersection B is null. Yeah, thank you. So A intersection B is null set, empty set, or phi. So you take any two of them and intersection will be null set. So we have A1, A2, A3, A4, A5 and so on. There are countably infinite events. So we are taking countable, so it is a sequence, you know already. So we have a sequence of events, then what is the probability of A1 union A2 union A3 and so on. So it will go till infinite. So this will be equal to probability of A1 plus probability of A2 plus probability of A3 and so on till infinite. So, or in other way, if you write in symbols, that is, you may write probability of union of AIs, okay. So, probability of union of AIs, I from 1 to N. So, N I'm taking to infinity, countable union. This is equal to summation probability of AI. Not N, since I'm taking countable union, so this. Same thing, the so writing this is same as writing this, okay. So what do you get? A is any event, so the probability of A is actually sum of the weights of all the sample point A, and therefore we may conclude probability of event A will be more than equal to 0, less than equal to 1, probability of null set is 0, probability of sample space is 1. Furthermore, if A1, A2, A3 and so on, these are sequence of mutually exclusive events, then probability of A1 union A2 union A3 and so on, this is equal to probability of A1 plus probability of A2. So the probability of union of AIs is equal to sum of probabilities of AIs, I from 1 to infinity. Okay. So this formula has name countable additivity. So this will hold only when you have mutually exclusive. Okay. So this is the definition. So let us solve one example. So the example is, a coin is tossed twice. Okay. A coin is tossed twice. So a coin is tossed twice. So question is, what is the probability that at least one head occurs? Okay, so please try and tell me the answer, all of you. You all can do this. So a coin is tossed twice. So what is the probability that at least one head will come? At least one head will occur. Yes, what is the answer? Tell me again. Okay. So a coin is tossed twice. So can anyone?
3/4.
Okay, so your answer is 3/4. Okay, let us check.
Yes, sir.
So you all know the sample space when we toss a coin twice. So both coin can show head, or first head, second tail, first tail, second head, or both can show tail. This is all possible outcomes. And we are interested in what? We are interested in at least one head occurs. So we are interested in at least one head occurs. Okay, so we name like event A as, A event is at least one head occurs. So at least one head occurs. So like A will contain what? So you have to select the outcomes which contain at least one head. So these three are at least one head, and either one head or more than one head. So these three outcomes from the sample space will qualify to be in A, and according to this condition, at least one head occurs. Now they will ask you what is probability of A. So you know, this sample space actually equally likely. Sample space is equally likely means each point has same probability. So you may write it like probability of A as probability of HH plus probability of HT plus probability of TH, and each will have probability 1/4. So 1/4 plus 1/4 plus 1/4, and that is 3/4. Directly you can write also 3/4. Okay, so yes, your answer is correct. Okay. Okay, so now,
please.
Next question is, so if an experiment can result in any one of the n different equally likely outcomes, and if there are exactly a small n number of outcomes are in A, then probability of A is this. So what they are saying, in a remark they are saying, like if sample space set of all possible outcomes, this has capital N number of equally likely outcomes. So equally likely means they have the same chance of occurring, equally likely outcomes. Okay, and if capital A, so it is event, so if event capital A contains small n number of outcomes, you may say, or sample points you can also say, so then probability of capital A will be what? So sample space contains how many outcomes? N, and set A contains small n. So what is the probability of event A? this I'm asking?
Small n by capital N.
Small n by capital N, correct? Okay, good. So small n by capital N. Now we come to the addition rule. So what is the addition rule of probability? Okay. So next is addition rule of probability. Addition rule of probability. So the theorem first tells us, theorem it is 0.1, and it is saying if A and B are two events, A and B are two events, then you all know this, I think. Okay, this is a sample space S, this is A, this is B, like that. You may take it A and this is B. So how do we write probability of A union B? What is the formula for this? Probability of A union B. You all are familiar with this, right? Already you might have seen these formulas, probability of A union B. So yes, what is the formula for probability of A union B?
Probability of A plus probability of B plus probability of A intersection B.
What, minus or plus? Minus, right?
Minus, sir.
Yes, yes. Good. So you can simply look here, probability of A plus probability of B. So this portion you are taking twice when you are adding probability of A plus B. That's why we are subtracting this. So this portion A is going to be, so we are subtracting. This is a formula. First formula, probability of A union B is PA plus PB minus PA intersection B. Okay. And in the we have restriction now. There is a corollary. So corollary is a result obtained from theorem. So corollary is what? If A and B are, so if A and B are mutually exclusive. Mutually exclusive. Okay. So if A and B are mutually exclusive. So mutually exclusive, you know, that is A intersection B is null set or phi or empty set. So what will be formula now for probability of A union B? So from the last formula, you may see. So if you see this formula, A intersection B is phi. So probability of A intersection B is 0. So it will be result. So this will be resulting this. Probability of A union B is PA plus PB. This is the formula. Okay, so when you have AB as mutually exclusive, we will have this formula. Next we have, like we have written here, so we may write the same thing. Here we have used that concept. If they are mutually exclusive, then we can write this. So we can generalize this formula. So if we generalize this formula, so this is corollary 1, let's say this is corollary 1, and now we write corollary 2. So corollary 2, if we write, so if A1, A2 and so on till AN, okay, these are mutually exclusive, then, so like we have written earlier, probability of union of AIs, now I from 1 to infinity, so here I'm not going to infinity, infinity was there, so I'm talking about n, now we have n number of events, so probability of union of AIs, I from 1 to n, this will be equal to summation of probability of AIs, I from 1 to n. So if you open it, like it is something, probability of A1 union A2 and so on union AN, this is equal to probability of A1 plus probability of A2 and so on till probability of a n. Okay. So this formula is actually called finite additivity. So both are same, either you write in this way or you write in this way. Okay. So equality will hold when you have mutually exclusive events. So you write equality in between. Okay, so next is next probability is so next probability is saying if a1, a2, a3 and so on an, this set, so this collection of these set is of partition of sample space. So it is saying if a1, a2, a3, an is partition of sample space S, then so what do you mean by partition actually? So see, suppose this is a sample space. So you divide it into n parts, like many parts you can divide. So suppose this is A1, now you may take it A2, A3, these are parts, A4 and so on. You may divide it, A5 and so on. So like last one would be AN, so sample, or in simple word if I understood, like partition means a union of all will contribute to sample space actually, and they are mutually disjoint. So if I define this word, what is the meaning of partition? So first let me define the partition. The partition means any two you will take intersection is empty, and union of all AIs 1 to n will be sample space. This is the meaning of partition. Like any two you will select from this a1, a2, an, intersection of any two will be an empty set, null set, and union of all you will take, it will contribute to sample space. Like for example, what I was making here, I was partitioning into n parts, no? So a1, a2, a3, a4, like this. You may not do all this simply, for example, so this is sample space. You divide this. So suppose this is A1, this is A2, this is A3, this is A4. So we have partitioned the sample space into four partitions, A1, A2, A3, A4. Similarly, in place of four, you have to divide into n parts. So it may be n part, okay? For example, this is suppose A1, this is A2 and so on. Last one is AN, like that. In between you can divide. So this is the partition of sample space into events, A1, A2, AN. So then what will happen? Then if they ask you what is probability of A1 union A2 union A3 and so on union AN. Okay. So according to formula, this will be so, you know, they are mutually exclusive. This is the definition, na, in the partition. So they are mutually exclusive. So you can write it as the sum of, and you may write it like probability of A1 plus probability of A2 and so on up to probability of AN. And sum of all will be nothing but probability of sample space, because union is sample space. Sample space probability is 1. So it will be 1. So simply the point here is, if you have A1 into AN as a partition of sample space, so probability of union of all will be 1. Okay, so if anyone is facing any doubt, you may ask. So next theorem we have generalization of addition formula. So theorem is, you may say theorem 0.2. for three events. For three events A, B, C. So what is the formula of A union B union C? Anyone would like to say what is the formula for probability of A union B union C? Yes, all of you know, I think. Mm-hmm. So it is probability of A plus probability of B plus probability of C. Okay, so one set I'm taking an addition minus probability of A intersection B minus probability of B intersection C minus probability of A intersection C plus probability of A intersection B intersection C. Okay, so we take one set at a time, two set at a time, then three set. Okay, so this is a formula for some formula for three events A, B, C. Next we have one term, so let's call 0.3. So to say, if A and A dash, or you may say A complement, are complementary event, this are complementary event. Means both are complement of each other. So sample space minus A will be A dash. Okay. Then what is the relation between probability of A and probability of A complement? So probability of A plus probability of A complement both will be 1. Or you may write it in other word, that is probability of A dash as 1 minus probability of A. Or you may write probability of A as 1 minus probability of A dash. Both are equivalent. Okay, any one of them you can write. So A dash means not A, no, complement of A. Okay, so let's try a few questions. So till now, any doubt? So where we started? We started with definition of probability of event. Okay, and then what is the addition formula, addition rule for 2, then we generalize it to n, no. Then for 3, then this for complementary event. So if you don't have any doubt, you please try this question. So question is, a pair of dice is tossed. Okay, a pair of dice is tossed. Find the probability of getting option A, first part of the question, a total of 8, and B part of the question, at most a total of 5. So all of you please try and tell me the answer. So pair of dice is tossed, and then I will solve. First you try. Thank you.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, is the answer of first one is 5/36.
Okay, 5/36. What about second part?
In second is.
Second is.
1/9 second.
1/9.
1/9.
Okay, 1/9. So everyone convinced. So we have to check if it's correct or not. At most total 5. At most, okay. So pair of dice, okay. So you know, one dice is thrown, the outcomes are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. When pair are thrown, so you have order pairs. So if I write the sample space, so okay, let me write the sample space. In the case of pair, it may 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4. Okay, 1, 5, 1, 6. Then maybe 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, 5, 2, 6. 3, 1, 3, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 3, 5, 3, 6. Okay, and then 4, 1, 4, 2, 4, 3, 4, 4, 4, 5, 4, 6. And 5, 1, 5, 2, 5, 3, 5, 4, 5, 5, 5, 6. Then 6, 1, 6, 2, 6, 3, 6, 4, 6, 5, 6, 6. So I have written all the outcomes. You know already what are these outcomes. There are 36 outcome total. So number of element in sample space is 36. When we solve a first part, A part, so A is total, okay, sum is 8, or outcome with the sum 8. So what are the outcomes in set A? So you will count those outcomes with sum 8. So can you tell me what are those outcomes? Sum 8. So it may be 6, 2, 5, 3, 4, 4, 3, 5, 2, 6. So these are the outcome, you can see. So how many are these?
5.
Okay, 5. So these are 6, 2, 5, 3, 4, 4, 3, 5, and 2, 6. So probability of A, so A contains 5 outcome out of 36. So you are right, answer is 5. Now come to B part. So in the B part, they asked you at most total of 5, at most total 5, at most. So at most, let me call event B. Okay, at most total 5. So at most total 5. So B will contain sum is 5 or less. Sum is 5 or less. So sum may be 2, here sum is 3, here sum is 4, and here sum is 5. Okay, not 1, 5. So
9/36.
Okay, 9/36. I will check. So these outcomes are those having sum is less than equal to 5. At most. So at most 10. Means sum is at most. So sum is less than equal to 5. 5 or less. 5 will also be counted. So sum 5 will also be counted. So you count that outcomes. 1, 2, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4.
10/36.
10. So 10/36.
Yes.
So outcomes if you write 1, 1, 1, 2. Okay. 1, 1, 1, 3. Then 2, 1. 1, 4 will also be counted because sum is 5. 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3. 2, 4 will not be counted. 3, 1, 3, 2, 3, 3 will not be counted. Then 4, 1 will be counted. then 5, 1 will not be counted because sum is at most 5. These are the outcomes. So how many are there? 10. There are 10. Or you can count here also. It is not necessary to write again. So probability of B, B contains 10 out of 36. So 5 by 18. Okay. So this is the answer. That is, so here you told this was wrong, this was right, okay. So this was the question. I will write the next question now. So the next question is, got it? So no doubt in this question. If you have doubt, you may ask. So next question is, in a poker hand consisting of 5 cards, so in a poker hand consisting of 5 cards, find the probability, of holding. So first part is 3 aces and second part is 4 hearts and 1 club. Okay, so you please try and tell me the answer quickly, otherwise I will solve. So means what? There are 52 cards, you already know. Out of these 52 cards, we have to draw 5 cards. And what is the probability that 5 card will contain 3 aces? This is the first question. And second question is, what is the probability that these 5 cards will contain 4 hearts and 1 club? Okay, so this is not difficult question. Okay, let me try. So you know this is a
pack. So the first answer is 4 by 52 into 3 by 51 into 2 by 50.
Okay, you simplify it and but we are selecting 5 cards. Okay, we have 52 cards in all. Okay, and we are selecting 5 cards. So first part, we are, so let me see first part, party I'm talking. So 5 card we have to draw, okay. So they are asking what is the chance that there will be 3 aces and 2 other card. They are asking this, 5 card we are drawing, so that 5 cards will contain 3 aces and 2 other card. Okay, total cards are how many? Total cards we have 52 cards. So tell me in 52 cards, how many aces are there?
4
aces are there and how many others card? 48. Okay, so now come to the question. Question is, what is the probability that 5 drawn card or 5 selected card will contain 3 aces? 5 selected card will contain or hold 3 aces. So look, first you have to decide the sample space, numerator, na? You know, number of favorable outcome upon total number of outcome. So first let us select what is the number of total possibility, number of element in sample space. Total 52 cards are there, we'll select 5 of them. This is 52, seat 5 is the total number of way of selecting 5 cards from 52 cards. So denominator will be 52C5 because we are selecting 5 cards from total 52. Now in numerator you have to find the probability of the number of elements favorable to event. Favorable to event this. So that 5 card should contain how many aces? There are 4 aces in all, and that must contain 3 aces. Okay, so you will select, you write 4C3. Why 4C3? 52 card contain 4 aces and you will select 3 of them. So 4C3 is the number of way of selecting 3 aces out of 4 aces. How many cards you have? 48. So 3 aces you selected. Now you want 2 other cards. So how many other cards are there? 48. So from the 48 rest card, you will select 2 of them because you want to select how many? 5 cards. So 3 aces and 2 others. Now you may simplify this. You know NCR formula. All of you know NCR formula. N factorial, R factorial, N minus R factorial. So use this formula. You can simplify this. So if you simplify, let me write the answer so that you may check later. So you will get answer something like 94 upon 54145. This you will get. Okay, now come to the second part. Second part says 4 hertz and 1 club. So now you can do it easily. B part. So what they are asking? In the B part, total 52 cards are there. We know that total 52 cards are there. That contains 4 hertz and that contains how many clubs? 4, sorry. So how many hertz are there? I did it by mistake. 13 hertz and 13 club. Is it right? And rest or like you can write 26 others. Others than hertz and club. Total cards contains this. We need to select 5 cards. That should contain how many hertz? 4 hertz and 1 club. So 4 hertz and 1 club. So 5 is here. So 0 from this. You know, 26 other. So 0 from others we want. 0 from others. So what is the probability of that 5 cards we selected contains 4 hertz and 1 club? Yes, so first you write total possibility. There are 52 cards, we are selecting 5 of them. Okay, there are 52, we are selecting 5 of them. The question is this 5 card will contain 4 hertz and 1 club. So how many hertz are there in total? 13. So 13C4, we are selecting 4 hertz out of 13, and there are 13 club and we want just one of them. This is enough. 5 card we took. No? You may write 26C0 or you may not write. Not necessarily. This is 1. For just understanding, I wrote this. So you may not write this. So this you can simplify and you will get something like 143 upon 39984. So do you have any doubt in this? What I'm solving? You may ask if you have something doubt.
Can you repeat?
Repeat which part? Part A or part B?
Part B.
Okay, so see, there are total 52 cards. So question is, we are selecting 5 cards. The total number of possibility, so it's a 52C5. This you can understand easily. So there are total 52 cards, we are selecting 5. So this is fine. This is a sample space. Now we want, I'm solving B part. What is the chance that 5 selected card will contain 4 hertz? So you know about card, I think. So I assume that you know about cards. So how many hearts are there? How many clubs are there? There are four suits: club, spade, heart, and diamond. All are 13, 13, 13, 13. So you wanted to select four hearts. So how many hearts are there? There are total 13 hearts. We want to select four, and it's multiplication. We want one club. So how many clubs are there? 13. How many want? We want one. So 13C1, 4 into 13C1 means out of 13 hearts, we selected four of them. Out of 13 club, we selected one of them because we wanted one in the question. Is it clear?
Yes.
And now you simplify. You know how to solve in CR, so you can solve it. Okay, let us solve one more. So the question is prove that. So if this type of questions they ask, how will you do? So question is prove that probability of A complement intersection B complement is equal to 1 plus probability of A intersection B minus probability of A minus probability of B. Okay, if they ask you to do this, so how will you do? Yeah, so how to solve this question? Okay, so let me start with LHS. Probability of A complement intersection B complement. Yeah, so do you know De Morgan's law? Anyone? What is the De Morgan's law? Or what can I write this? A complement intersection B complement can be written as what? In other way.
A union B the whole day.
Yeah, good. So A union B hold as or complement. So we may write it A union B whole complement. Okay. So A union B hold as. And now to remove this dash, you know the formula of complement. So probability of A complement is equal to 1
minus PA union B.
Yeah, good. 1 minus PA union B. And now you know already what is the formula of A union B, right? This you know. So it's a PA plus PB minus PA intersection. Just you simplify. So this is the answer what we wanted. Just the trick was just to use De Morgan's law and then open the complement. Then you will get. So it is 1 minus probability of A minus probability of B plus probability of A intersection. And that's what we wanted to prove. Yes. So you may rewrite in a good way like they have expected you. So probability of A intersection B minus PA minus PB. So this is the answer. So this you can do easily. Just here I use De Morgan's law. Then probability of A complement is 1 minus probability of A. Use that. Okay, so okay, let's try one more. So the question they are asking you, in experiment involves tossing a pair of dice, one green and one red. Okay, there are two dice, one green dice and die, and the other is red. Recording the number that comes up. If x equal to the outcome on the green die, so C, right. So there are two dice, okay, one is green, one is red, and so there are two dice we are throwing. So x is the number outcome on the green dice, y is the outcome on the red die. Assuming that all elements of sample space are equally likely to occur, let capital A be the event that sum is greater than 8, and capital B be the event that 2 occurs on either die, C be the event that a greater number than 4 come up on the green die. Okay. So how do you write sample space? It is like that, x comma y such that, okay, x, y can take value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So all 36 outcome I write in this symbolic way. This is called set builder form. So there are 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3 and so on. So first die, they are saying that you assume that first die is green and second one is red. So first you assume green die and second you assume red die. Outcomes, okay? So the A event, they are saying event A is sum is greater than 8. Okay, it's the sum on both die, sum is greater than 8. So like sum is more than 8. B event is 2 occurs on either die. So B is 2 occurs on either die. Okay, and C is a number greater than 4 comes up on green die. A number greater than 4 comes up green die is first die. Okay, number greater than 4 comes up on green die. Green is the first die. So question, what is probability of A, what is probability of C? So this you can find easily, you know, we have written sample space earlier. So what is probability of A? So you may count how many are sum is more than 8.
5 by 18.
5 by 18. How? So here we have written all 36 outcomes. Yeah, here. So
first question.
Yes, yes. So here you may check total sum is 8. So here is sum is A event is that sum is greater than 8. So greater than 8 means how many outcomes you count this. This is sum 8. Here you get sum 7. Here you will get sum. Oh, sorry. Here sum 9, sum 10, sum 11, sum 12. So these are the, you know, here is sum 8, then sum 9, sum 10, sum 11, sum 12, like this. So you add how many outcomes are there with sum more than equal to 8. So 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5. How many are this? 5 plus 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1. Oh, more than 8. Okay, sorry. More than 8 means you will start from here. Sum is 9, 10, 11, 12. Add this. So one outcome having sum 12, two outcome having sum 11, three outcomes having sum 10, and four outcomes having sum 9. So you add all four. 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. So they are 10. Okay. So simply they are 10 out of 36. Similarly, you can do. They ask you probability of B and C. So you can do using writing all the sample space. Okay. So if you have any doubt, you may ask. So I'm taking screenshot of this. Okay. So I will stop here. Yes. Yes, yes, please ask.
Second one, is it 11 by 36?
Okay, so I have to check. So second one, you are checking for probability of B, right? So what is probability of B? 2 occurs on either die. So you may check how many. Okay, so you are saying 11 upon 36. Okay, yes. So 2, 2 will be counted twice. Yes. 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, like this. And then 2, 1, 2, 2. Yeah.
The third one, it is 1 by 3.
Third one, it is a number greater than 4 comes up on green die. So green die means the first die has 4. So 4, 5, 6. More than 4. Okay. Greater than 4. Okay. 5 or 6. So 5 or 6 means 5, 1, 5, 2, 5, 6. Tak. 6, 1, 6, 2, 6. There are 12 out of 36. You are saying this? Yeah. Yes, yes. Then they may ask you what is probability of A intersection C and all this. So you can find easily. You just check A and C means A will occur as well as C will occur. Then you take the common outcomes from sample space and then you can write. Okay, so any more doubt anyone would like to ask? If you don't have doubt, then we can finish here. Yeah, thank you everyone. So we'll see you in next class.
Ciao. Thank you, sir.
Yes, what are you saying?
Sir, previous there was a math.
Aprithi ma'am will take class, so she is on leave. So she will, when she will come, she will continue. So okay. She is on leave, yeah.
Thank you.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.